I've been working with Penn State for about 20 years, and for about 18 years since Steve came in the Franklin County Extension, we have been working together as a team. And I think Steve has been very helpful in a lot of aspects. Tomatoes are a very important crop to our farm, and high quality fruit is always very important. And I think they do a good job on research that helps us do a better job in producing quality fruits and vegetables, and also in the horticulture line.
Penn State Extension is an outreach arm of the Penn State College of Agricultural Sciences. We provide practical information to growers and other Pennsylvanians based on research conducted at Penn State, other land-grant universities, and government research agencies. Penn State Extension is a network of faculty and staff on campus and educators spread across Pennsylvania in county-based offices and our regional research farms. South Central Pennsylvania is a major area of commercial fruit, vegetable, and flower production. One of the factors that has helped to stimulate this area into a produce and flower powerhouse is that nearly 60% of the U.S. population is within 12 driving hours using our extensive highway network. Hi, I'm Steve Bogash, a commercial horticulture educator with Penn State Extension. I've been a commercial horticulture educator and researcher with Penn State for nearly 18 years. My focus is on improving vegetable crops and helping growers adopt new practices. Like my Penn State Extension colleagues, I teach workshops to growers to keep them up to date on the latest practices and to help new growers get started. Strawberries are a vital part of the early cash flow here in the valley.
About 10 years ago, we were having problems with getting quality plugs.
We put together a team that included faculty extension and land grant contracts and helped Reuben get started.
We feel that we have been able to maintain a quality plug for our own use and for other farmers in Pennsylvania and surrounding states.
Water quality and quantity are vital issues in producing high quality produce. The Extension family of specialists includes members of our water team. Their support has been one part of the structure that has helped to grow horticulture in the Cumberland Valley.
Water is a vital part of agriculture, especially for crops that depend on irrigation. Strawberry transplants and other crops that are grown in the greenhouse are sheltered from the rain, and so they need to be watered. Strawberry plants out in the field can be watered using a drip irrigation system, and that's an efficient way to get water right to the roots where it's needed without increasing plant disease. Hi, I'm Amy Gelford. I'm a water resources educator for Penn State Extension based in the Cumberland County office, and I work throughout this region. I'm part of the State Water Resources Extension team, and we've been developing new partnerships with the horticulture educators at Penn State Extension to improve the information we provide growers about water quality, water treatment, and food safety issues. The Cumberland Valley has limestone-based soils that are great for growing some crops, but minerals that dissolve change the water chemistry in ways that can make it difficult to grow other crops.
Water quality has been on my mind for quite a few years, and we started using this little tool here will give me a reading on water quality for the plants, the pH, the EC, which is the nutrients in the water. And I think this tool is always handy for me, and it's very easy to use.
Reuben hosted a meeting here at Maplewood Produce for growers to come and learn about the strawberry varieties he was growing out in his fields, and also to learn from Extension about the role that irrigation water can play in growing their crops. Farmers brought in their own samples to be tested, and some of them were surprised by the results that they got and took home with them that night. Flowers such as petunias actually like acidic irrigation water, and Reuben was already adjusting the pH of his water for growing flowers. It turns out that tomatoes also prefer acidic irrigation water, and it can affect how they take up nutrients like potassium. If they can't take up those nutrients, they can actually end up with poor quality fruit that's unmarketable. So Reuben worked with Steve to improve the quality of his irrigation water, and therefore improve the quality of the tomatoes he was selling.